And I love you so. The people ask me how I've lived till now. I tell them I don't know. I guess they understand how lonely life has been. But life began again the day you took my hand. And yes, I know how lonely life can be. The shadows follow me, and the night won't set me free. But I won't let the evening get me down. Now that you're around me, and you love me too. Your thoughts are just for me. You set my spirit free. I'm happy that you do. The book of life is brief, and once a page is read, oh, but love is dead. That is my belief. And yes, I know how loveless life can be. The shadow. Set me free, but I don't let the evening get me down. Now that you're around me, and I love you so. The people ask me how I've lived till now. I tell them I don't know. Yes to me. quando you mean happiness to me. Oh, my love, please tell me when every moment's a day, every day seems a lifetime. Let me show you the way to a joy beyond compare. I can't wait a moment more. Tell me quando. Just say it's me that you adore. And then, darling, tell me when. Devi dirlo perché non ha senso per me. La mia vita senza te. Dimmi quando tu verrai. Dimmi quando. E baciando mi dirai, non ci lasceremo mai. Non ci lasceremo mai. Non ci lasceremo mai. Dimmi quando, amore, quando.
Non ti si può pigliare come sei. I tuoi difetti sono talmente tanti che nemmeno tu li sai. Sei peggio di un bambino capriccioso, la vuoi sempre vinta tu. Sei l'uomo più egoista e prepotente che abbia conosciuto mai. Ma c'è di buono che al momento giusto tu sai diventare un altro. In un attimo tu
Sei grande, 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 le mie pene non me le ricordo più. Io vedo tutte quante le mie amiche, son tranquille più di me. Non devono discutere ogni cosa come tu fai fare a me. Ricevono regali e rose rosse per il loro compleanno. Dico sempre di sì. Non hanno mai problemi e sono convinte che la vita è tutta lì. Invece no, la vita è quella che tu dai a me. In guerra tutti i giorni sono viva, sono come piace a te. Ti odio, poi ti amo, poi ti odio, poi ti odio, poi ti amo. Non lasciarmi mai più. Sei grande, grande, grande come te, sei grande solamente tu. Ti odio, poi ti amo, poi ti odio, poi ti odio, poi ti amo. Non lasciarmi mai più. Sei grande, grande, grande come te, sei grande solamente tu. Sei grande, grande, grande come te, sei grande solamente tu.
The sun, well, the sun really came out. Giada live from Las Vegas, and I decided to make the little leader that you're gonna see every day. Here comes the sun, because you guys always say that I bring some joy into your house. You bring joy in mine up here and there. And today we did, I asked yesterday, all of you guys, if you liked it to hear some music before. And I saw that some of you were already tuned in 15 minutes before showtime, and you were enjoying some of my songs. And actually Rich from Liverpool and Antonio were there. You guys told me that you were able to listen to the music. And so how are you guys? Come state? And JJ, you should put also on maybe Instagram. We keep forgetting the Instagram people. So... Yeah, we are live also on Instagram, guys. Buongiorno, this is Giada from Las Vegas. Let me repeat my hello for you guys on Facebook. Due del pomeriggio, actually 2:03, due del pomeriggio a Las Vegas, 2 p.m. and 3 second. And what time is where you are in the world? And where are you watching from? And how are you feeling? Those are my questions every day. And you guys are every day so nice and kind to answer my question. Yesterday, actually, we had people from, from Italy, the USA, from France, from England, from Ireland. We had Germany, Argentina, Australia, Canada, and the Netherlands yesterday. So we are basically reaching out the whole world. So where are you guys watching from today? I can see some of you. I know that, Antonio, you're watching from Dublin. Antonio Argentieri is a fantastic chef, for pastry chef, that makes amazing things. Not just he makes cakes, he makes work of art. One of these days I have to chit-chat with him too and see if I can show you some of his work. And then, of course, I have my dear friend Richard Unger from Liverpool. I'm always mentioning Richard because I'm grateful to Richard because he bought me a tripod to put my phone. So you guys on Instagram are able to see what we are doing here, thanks to the tripod that I got all the way from Liverpool, from Richard. And what else? I don't know if he's already appearing, but is Doug over there from Sacramento. Doug bought a mixer, so we are able to sing every day. Actually, tomorrow, talking about singing, domani ci sarà il concerto. You know, I ask you, vi ho chiesto la scorsa settimana if you prefer to have the concert on Fridays or Sundays. And you, majority of you said Sunday. Of course, now I made some other people unhappy because Friday was better for them. So I'm so sorry. But the good thing is that you're always able to see those video on repeat. Either here on Facebook, you guys on Instagram, it will disappear after 24 hours. But if you want to see what the guys are seeing on Facebook with pictures and everything, you can go on my page, which is giada.live. Giada.live, and you can see all the videos in the same way the guys on Facebook sees, because for the guys on Facebook I even made a leader, an opening leader, here comes the sound, to do do do. So if you want to see all this stuff I'm making, you can go on giada.live after you're done with this Instagram, and you can have a better view of what I'm doing. We haven't figured out a way yet to have a better way to connect with you guys on Instagram. And unfortunately, Instagram is the only outlet, the only platform that we cannot put inside the system of StreamYard. All the other we can. So we are live on Facebook. We are live on YouTube. We are live on Periscope, on Twitch, on LinkedIn, on Twitter. So we all the platform, even the one that I've never was aware of, like Twitch and Periscope, we are live there, but we cannot integrate Instagram. Instagram is still outside all this, all the others. So we have to have two different things. As soon as that's possible, of course, you know me, I will connect you all together. So you can see how many wonderful people we have every day, also on Facebook and on Twitter and on YouTube and everywhere, and how many wonderful people you guys are missing there on Instagram. Is anybody on Instagram that we have to say hello, JJ? Not yet. There's nobody. They're there, but they didn't write anything. Guys, if you don't write a message, I cannot answer back to you. So what else? So tomorrow is going to be the concert. So tomorrow is going to be a lot of music. And I want to thank also, of course, Doug from Sacramento. He normally is always with us, with Susie from Sacramento. He bought a mixer. So because of him, he sponsored the music. So thank you, Doug, for that. And sorry that I bumped into the microphone. Did I make it like boom? I'm sorry. I forget that I have a little mic here. You see my little microphone here? So how is the sound of my voice when I talk to you? Can you hear me? Because I remember last week when we were making, we made a chocolate salami last week. Some of you have difficulty to hear me, also you guys on Instagram. So we have now this microphone and hopefully the sound is going to be better. So Rich, I know that you are a technicians out there. So put thumbs up if the sound is good. I see a lot of you appearing today. So we're cooking. We are here in my kitchen. As you see, I was just complaining to my husband and I need a bigger place here to put everything. Look how congested is my in front of me. Quante cose c'ho qua davanti. Ho bisogno di una piattaforma più grande per cucinare. But today I make for you a recipe, actually, that my mom made already ever since I grew up with this recipe. And for different reasons. It's easy to make, è una ricetta che è facile da fare, and sometimes you can make it with the leftover of pasta. You know, sometimes in Italy we cook too much pasta, short pasta, and then what do we do with pasta? We eat it the day after, or we warm it up and we add oil and cheese and stuff, or we make the dish that I show you today. But it's also a nice dish to make on Sundays. Because it's or make it on Saturday. So on Sunday, if you don't want to cook, you can warm it up and have it again. It's basically is pasta al forno al ragù bianco, which is baked pasta with white sauce. It's very simple. It's not rocket science. You know, I am a singer. For the one of you watching that maybe have no idea who I am Giada from Las Vegas, and I am a professional singer. So singing is my thing. And cooking is just something I love because I love to eat good food. And I post today a quote that Martin Scorsese said, why going to a restaurant when your mother can cook Italian food? Which is true. That's been me growing up. We haven't gone much in restaurants because between my mama and my grandmother, there was always so much food. And my grandmother from the south of Italy, my mother and father, we lived in Venice, but my grandmother and grandfather, and so my father is from the south. So my nonna in the south was also very, very good chef. Two different kind of recipe. Maybe one of these days I can cook, this is something more from the north. Maybe one of these days I can cook for you more a recipe from the Ciociaria, the region where my grandma was from. So more in the south. I know that some of you asked me if there's differences between the regions of Italy food-wise, and is completely different. For instance, I am Venetian, so we cook a lot of things with rice and a lot of things with fish because we have water. And in Italy, all the regions have specific things that they grow, and we like to eat what we are producing. So, for instance, if you go deep in the sound, you find a lot of recipe with melanzane, with tomatoes. And the north, we have more kind of rice, mushrooms, and fish kind of things. And every region has a plate that they are very famous from. Venice has several recipes. The risotto, I would say, the rice with the things, the risottos are one of the most famous one with fishes. I don't know if Diane Fiorentino already appeared. I've been so busy preparing all these things. It starts to become like a joyful work because it's really a full-time job. So I want to thank all of you that are supporting me in this endeavor of me or appearing every day with your donation because it's really like a full-time job. What I did today, I woke up at 8 this morning. I had to prepare all the cards that you see appearing. They have to be on a certain form. I have to write the recipe, collect them, translate it from write them down in Italian, then translate it for myself into English, find the pictures. I have Natalie all the way in Toulouse that she helps me to prepare all the stuff. Thank God she's my assistant far away from me, but thank God she's doing so. Natalie, I know you're watching today, so I thank you for that. And then, of course, you will see every time I cook something for you, I have to prepare the final product I had. I've learned that when I started to make these presentations on television. So on television, they give you 3 minutes. So you have to prepare any dish, pasta, cooked or raw, whatever. You have to have it ready because in 3 minutes, you have to explain the ingredients and you have to assemble it and show it like if it's cooked, how it's going to be cooked. And then you have to have it ready in 3 minutes and be there with the presenter testing the food. So I've learned that I have to prepare everything. So basically this morning at 8 o'clock, I was cooking this recipe. I have already one ready that I will show you in a second. And especially also today is also the birthday of my friend Gina here in Las Vegas. Happy birthday, Gina. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Gina. Happy birthday to you. She's been watching me every day together with Wes. They watch from YouTube because they don't have Facebook. And so this morning, yesterday afternoon, I cooked this recipe and I cooked my own lunch and my own breakfast. And yesterday I made a tiramisu for Gina. I know she loves my tiramisu. And of course, we cannot celebrate together, Gina, but I prepare one for you. And as soon as we are done with this one, I will step into my car. I will ring the bell and leave it on the footstep for you. I made a big one so you can share it with your whole family. They are in quarantine with the 5 of them. So I made a good size one. So later you can have the tiramisu. I know you love my tiramisu. So I've been cooking. And of course, in between, I also have to prepare for the concert of tomorrow. We got some lights in. I told you that we are trying to upgrade also the background. while we're doing these appearances. So yesterday I got delivered, thanks to Natalie, who supported who bought it for me basically on Amazon. We have now this beautiful green screen. It's huge, it's gonna be big, and we will be able to have something on the background. So, you know, everything that is green is gonna take the color of a picture. So I can be appearing to you in Rome, in Venice, in Florence, a Parigi, who knows? I can be on a beach. I can be in the inside of a theater. So, but this is gonna happen to next week because we have to test how it works with the lights and everything. So what about guys that, please let me know where you're watching from. I see a lot of new people appearing. So where are you watching from and how are you doing? Guys, da dove ci state guardando e come state? This quarantine is gonna take longer than what we think. So we have to be creative in finding a new way of keeping happy. And I want to thank you for being with me every day. So today we are cooking. We do it every Saturday. So John Katz already announced it last week, so it was not even way for me to change the recipe. So today we make pasta al forno al ragù bianco, baked pasta. There it is. That's the final dish. Thank you, JJ. And there's the baked pasta with white sauce. So here we go. Let's start with the ingredient. You know, all the recipe, the Italian recipe, have a few ingredients and they are very easy to make. But let's start with the time of preparation. I made a card for you so you guys can read there with over how long it's going to take. So it's going to take more or less 30 minutes to be made. Cooking time is 25 minutes and it's going to be ready in 55 minutes because, of course, he has to stay also in oven for a little bit to warm up. So that's going to be like 25 minutes in the oven. And these are the ingredients. They are two different. We have to make the white sauce, then we have to make the bechamel. So this is the white sauce, the white ragu, as we like to call. You see, we need the ground beef, we need peas, we need carrots, celery and onion, salt and pepper to taste. Olive oil, of course. This is an addition that does my mom, is oregano, which is fantastic. And then the bechamel, which is this white sauce, 1 cup of it we're going to make of it. And here are the ingredients, as you can see. I have here the ground meat, already make sure that it's already in little pieces. Then I have already cut everything in pieces to speed it up. Here are the carrots. Here are the onions. Here is the celery. Never forget to make it, to put in your ragù the celery. It really gives a very fresh and nice taste. A voi ragazzi in Italia non ve lo devo dire che per fare il ragù aggiungiamo il sedano e diventa buonissimo. Qui in America magari non lo mettono sempre. And of course I have le mie spezie, so I have here my spices. I have a chili powder. I really love to put it everywhere, peperoncino in pezzettini. I like the oregano because it gives a very nice taste to the ragù. And of course a little bit of salt. And my olive oil. Here it's my olive oil. So that's very easy. Since I cannot take you to the stove, I explain you what we're gonna do. You take like a pan like this one. You're gonna put your oil, your onions inside like this one. You're gonna add some olive oil. You sparkle just a little bit, as much as you want. I would say not too much. And this one, basically, I have also a picture. You're gonna put it on the stove and cook it like for 10 minutes until the onions is gonna turn a little bit brown. So we'll come back here. So you put it on the stove, you cook it for 10 minutes. When that's brown, you're gonna add on the ingredients. I can take it actually show you. You're gonna put your carrots and put it with my hands inside. You're gonna put the carrots and the celery. So basically, but then you do it, of course, when the onions is a little bit brown. And you're gonna add some peperoncino, pepper chili powder. You put some oregano and a little bit of salt. Not too much because we're gonna add cheese at the end, so you don't wanna want. This one, I will say, he has to cook for maybe like 50 minutes until it's nice and sauteed, quindi è abbastanza tenero. Potete aggiungere anche un po' di acqua. You can add a little bit of water. You can also add a little bit of white wine while you're cooking it if you like to. I don't, but if you like, you can add some white wine. When you're done with this one, you take half can of your peas, the brown peas, and you put it inside as well. And when you add that one, you cook it for other 5 minutes, and then you put inside as the last one, you put inside your meat. you're gonna cook, let's say, when the meat is inside, when the vegetables are all nice and sauteed, cucinati un po', you're gonna put the meat, and he has to cook for extra 20 minutes. You wanna make sure that all your meat is nice and cooked, even though it's gonna be cooked in the oven again. So I would say like maybe 15, 20 minutes with the meat. When you're done, JJ, you can show the picture. This is the way it's gonna look like. It's delicious. If you take a spoon and you taste it, you're gonna love it. I have it also here ready for you, of course. I made it last night. In a second, we're gonna assemble everything. So I have it here. And while you're doing this, I have to take you to the stove because the only thing I could not prepare in advance is the white sauce, the bechamel. So let me warm up. I put in this thing. Here are the ingredients to make the bechamel. If you've never done it, you need some butter. You need some flour and some heated milk and salt. So basically, let me put this one back on the fire. So here are my ingredients, the butter, more or less like 2 spoons, if you saw, some flours and heated milk. So of course, this one here is not heated. So I'm eating the milk and the butter. So you put the butter and the milk together here on the stove. I hope you guys can see me. And you start to boil it. Let me hire the fire. So as soon as the milk is boiling, you're gonna add some people say little by little. Me, I put it in all together. If you put it in a little by little, less chances that you are gonna get naughty, we call. So that it's gonna be easier for you to stir. If you have more time, you put it in a little by little and you stir it. And you notice that while the milk and the butter are boiling, it's gonna get harder. So, I'll show you in a second. I think my milk is already cooking. So I take my flour, it's hot, and I'm gonna put it in. And I start to stir my flours. JJ, I think you also have a picture that you can show how at the end, how is it gonna turn out, the bechamel. If you guys have never met it, bechamel actually is you see, that's gonna be the contest like that. So bechamel actually is something French. I know that do we have French people watching beside Natalie and Veronique? You guys invented, and you're gonna put some salt. I have some extra salt here. So make sure that you had some salt. As I said, no much, because there is gonna be cheese, provolone cheese inside. Yeah, then you can see that. So the water is already boiling, the milk is already boiling, and it's done in a second. You stir it very powerfully. Voila, that's what I'm doing. And when it starts to get hard, you switch it off. And here's your bechamel. I can bring it to the camera. Maybe you can see it. So easy it is to make this sauce. Let me see. If you notice that it's a little bit hard, like in my case, I'm gonna add a little bit of milk. Normally, I'll show it to you. I don't know if you guys can see. Let me bring it to the stove for a second. Because the milk needs to be a little bit warm. And here it is. So JJ, show you how it's gonna be. She can show you again the pictures of the bechamel, JJ. Voila. Yeah, I'm sorry guys that I cannot take you all the way to my stove here. With JJ, we are actually trying to perfect in this kind of live things. Can you guys see me and hear me from there? They can still see me. So I'm stirring. If you're watching now, sto facendo la bechamel. So che la mia mamma e il mio papà ci guardano ogni giorno. Most of the time, più delle volte, mom and dad, you're watching me the day after because it's already midnight. Yeah, I'm making some noise here. So my bechamel is ready, so I can switch it off. So when we're done, so my mom and dad are watching. Mama, you guardi domani la mattina. She's very proud of me because I told her the other day that I'm very blessed that she told me how to cook. So nowadays that I cannot go to any place, even if I wanted to go to any place, I have to stay home. I know how to feed myself. And I even know how to teach you to feed yourself and make some stuff. So here is my nice white sauce. Let's put this one in there. And when we're done with this one, we can start to assemble our recipe. If you're just watching and tuning in, we are making baked pasta with white sauce. Is there any question, JJ? People's asking anything? Not yet. So you guys, you know, you can ask me something. So here we go. We're gonna assemble all the pasta dish together. So, In the meantime, you also preheat the oven because we're going to eat the oven. So you preheat the oven, I think 425, JJ, there must be a card that say to them how they can preheat the oven, how, which temperature. I think I made one. JJ is looking for it. There we go. No, that's the bechamel. Yeah, there's the ingredients. Oh, so anyway, the oven needs to be preheated. Maybe you find it. So the oven needs to be preheated 425 Fahrenheit, which is 180 Celsius. I remember that. And then you have to cook this one for 25 minutes. But let's assemble our dish. So you take the white sauce that we made before with the onions, the celery, the carrots, and the meat, and you put it in a big bowl like this one. Here we go. We put the big bowl. We put all inside like this one. You had to eat the bechamel that we made it. Here we go. Nice and creamy. By the way, if you never made it before, you can take a spoon and taste it. It's delicious. Check it a little bit. Before it was a little bit hard, so you saw me that I put some extra milk because it needs to be a little bit watering. Because it needs to also to cook in the oven and you want your dish to stay a little bit tasteful. So you take this one and you put them all together. You mix them all together. Are you guys enjoying this? It's easy. It's fun. Actually, I started to make this one already when I was a little girl because my mama and my nonna were cooking for the stuff. And then I was able to do what I'm doing now. That was my job, to assemble everything. So at this point, you can add some extra oregano if you like. I like it, so I always put some extra oregano on it. I put it already in the other one. And you add your cheese. I already cut it for you. My choice of cheese is provolone cheese because I like the taste of it. It's very salty, it's delicious. So I cut it in little pieces that you can see. And you add it to your sauce here. Very nice and easy. And you keep putting all the stuff together. Can the guys see the inside? Here we go. You can. So here we are. As you can imagine, when it goes to the oven, this one is going to be melting. It's going to be delicious. So I have grated also some Parmesan cheese. If you want, you can put also some inside. And listen, since I'm in America, I don't know guys where you are watching from, but in America, they have a lot of... they sell cheeses that is already grated. Like, for instance, this is one that I really like. It's three cheeses. It's already grated, and you bite it in a little things already done. I like to sprinkle it on the top of it. We don't do that in Italy, but I've learned to do it here in America, so it becomes nice and crusty. So when you have mixed the whole thing, you have to put the other ingredient, the most important one, the short pasta, because this is pasta al forno. After all, it's baked pasta. So what you can do, if you're not very good in handling 27 pan and pots cooking on the same time, because listen, normally if I have to make this for my family, I cook everything together. So I start making this ragu, then I bake the bechamel while the water of the pasta is already cooking. So if you're not very good in juggling all these things together, you do like I did today, like we do a lot of time in Italy. We cook the pasta in the morning, or we do this recipe when we have some leftover. See, it was some pasta that I cooked this morning. It's eatable, but it's a little bit very, very al dente. So let's say if in your package is written like this one, that the pasta needs to cook for 8 minutes, you cook it for 6. So it stays nice and hard. And then you can put it in the refrigerator. Maybe if you made it the day before, and then you put it in this dish. So here is my pasta. I'm going to put it inside. And what do? We stirred all the things together. It is so much fun. I remember as a little girl, I was doing this one with music. Actually, we were supposed to have music also today, but I'm going to sing something a cappella so for you while I'm doing this one. But normally we were doing this with music, and I know many of you ask, al di là del bene più prezioso ci sei tu, al di là. I know that many of you asked me this song, which I never sang it because I haven't found a backing track yet, but it's funny that you guys ask this song because this is one of the songs that my grandmother used to sing. My grandmother was an amazing, great singer. And this one was one of her favorite songs. So actually, I should find maybe next time a recording of Nilla Pizzi, which was the singer in Italy that made this song famous. And just have it, the music in the background, or some music play for you. And here we are, believe it or not, this is all assembled together, as you can see. Let me show you. It's going to look like this. You can eat it also like this without putting it in the oven, because it's everything is actually cooked. You see, JJ also has a nice picture. Thank you for that. But we like it, put it in the oven, so it's going to be crusty, it's going to be crunchy, and it's going to be delicious. So when we are done with this one, guess what? What are we going to do? By the way, look what I have here today in my kitchen. Thanks to Ronnie Manicotti, he sent me from Cincinnati. He sent me a series of these nice kitchen clothes. And this is my favorite. Just beat it. Just beat it. I was beating all the things here together. So thank you, Ronnie, for sending me this one. He sent me three. So every week we're going to have a new one. And some people of you are wondering what is in my apron here. Well, I've been for several years a member of Accademia della Cucina Italiana, which is an important organization that we have in Italy and all around the world that guarantee that restaurants in the world are making food that is authentic to the Italian tradition. So I've been a member for many, many, many years, ever since I was living in Amsterdam. And it's a beautiful way to have other people that just like me, stay in contact with other people that just like me love good food. And once a month, we are doing these dinners in Italian restaurants, and we write a review to say the food. Because in many, many, many times, you know, Italian restaurants, they have to adapt a little bit to the country, because they find certain ingredients. But of course, they have to keep on to the tradition. So that's what the academia does, basically. So then there is a book for all the academici, for the academia, and we can say, if we go to Dublin, for instance, we can take the book and see that in Dublin there is a certain restaurant that serves the most authentic Italian food possible. So that's what I did. Some people were asking, and they gave you sometimes also items like this one, and I love to wear it while I'm in the kitchen, thinking about to my country, my beautiful country. And we are ready to roll, rock and roll. So everything is assembled, if you've been following. And guess what? We take a tray like this one that you can put in the oven. So this is my tray. And we're going to put all these things we have been making. We're going to pour it in. This is so much fun. As I said, if you're quarantining with your kids, when you have, of course, they cannot stay behind the stuff, but maybe you can do like my grandma was doing with me, that this was my job, to put it nicely on a pan and create this kind of nice things. Look at that. Of course, you try to make it as nice and smooth as you can, because this is going to be also the dish that is going to appear on your table. So I know JJ look at me, I would say, make it as most beautiful as possible. So I'm building it as more beautiful as possible. JJ is like an engineer, everything. And I always say, kitchen is not an engineering, but JJ likes everything well prepared, which I'm doing my best to do it to prepare. If JJ were here, I would say, get off of there, let me show you. But I'm doing a good job. Am I doing a good job, guys? So here we go. You try to make it as smooth as possible. Do I have your approval? JJ said, thumbs up. Hey, we did it for today, guys. So we are quarantining with the two of us. How many of you are quarantining over there? Who is along? Who is with you? Are you missing anybody? By the way, if you want me tomorrow to dedicate a song to somebody that is far away from you, just let me know and I do. So Antonio, do you have somebody? You have friends all over Europe. Also you, I know, Richard, and all of you watching. Who is there? Is he watching somebody, JJ, that never watched before? Oh, Irene. Irene from Pittsburgh?
No, Irene from
Las Vegas? Irene Poreda from Las Vegas. Hello, Irene. So I have to call you Irene. So here it is. This is basically your pasta. Before you put it in the oven, though, as I said before, you have to sparkle it with the good stuff. So you have make sure that you have Parmesan cheese already grated. This is my thing. And you sparkle this one. While I'm doing this one, Georgia, I think I took a picture of how it looks before it goes to the oven. So you can see how it's going to look from close by. Hey, here we go. So you put everywhere this little cheese like that. As I told you before, I spoiled myself a little bit and the recipe, because as I told you, here in America, we find these nice cheeses. There are different cheeses altogether. I like to put sparkle a little bit of it. I did it also on the one I made yesterday, and it looks so pretty. And you guys saw also the recipe I made for my cauliflower. I know many of you were asking for that recipe too. I will give you the recipe soon too. And here we go. And basically, your baked pasta, it's ready to go in the oven. As I said, the oven is already preheated of 425 Fahrenheit, and I think it's 180 on Celsius, quindi 180 gradi. And deve cucinare per 25 minuti. It has to cook like for 25 minutes. So I'm going to put this one in the oven. I'm going to eat this, of course, tomorrow, but I have prepared one already that I can show you how it looks like. Give me a second. It is, voila, nice and crunchy. This was cooked this morning. It's still a little bit tepid because it's a little bit warm. Now I can touch the thing. Of course, it was in the oven for 25 minutes. And since I know they always say that we need to close eating food, that's what we do on TV when I cook on TV. So we cook the whole things and then we are tasting. And that's the most fun of for everybody. We have people coming down on the television studio from all the offices, the newsmen and the weather. I miss doing that. I miss really being around, going around the country. It's very joyful and beautiful to prepare food. And then you have people coming from all over the building. They said, is Giada here? What did she cook today? And they come down and they enjoy the food. So I hope you guys are going to make this recipe because it's very easy and believe me, you're going to love it. So let me make space here because I'm going to cut a little piece and me and JJ, we're going to have lunch while you're watching us. I know it's rude, right? Siamo un po' brutto vedere che noi mangiamo e non mangiamo. But you know what? You have to make it. And if you make it, please take a picture. First of all, you're going to love it. And just send me a picture of you making. So you cut the whole cake like this, what I normally do. I cut it all in little square thing because it's easy to cut. Make a small or big pieces as much as you want. Me, I'm going to take this one. Let me see. Here we go. Can you see it? I'm going to put it here. I'm going to take the plates up in a second so you can see it. So this is my lunch today. So you know, I don't have to tell you tomorrow what I had for lunch today. So let me serve also first. I want to show you how it looks like. This is for my cameraman. It smells fantastic. Guys on Instagram, can you see? This is for my cameraman, JJ, buon appetito. And this, of course, is my piece. I wish you guys could smell how delicious this smells. I normally put, somebody is asking, what is that? I put some Parmesan cheese around my plate. So, well, and what I normally do, I forgot I'm doing the plate of JJ. I also had some olive oil like this, all around the plate. So when I take a piece, look at this. We do like this. It's delicious. I take a little bit of the cheese and the olive oil. And it's delicious. JJ, how is it?
It's great.
It's great. Actually, the best part of it is the top of it. This it's just delicious, okay? So I hope you enjoy this recipe. If people enjoying this, watching, oh, I see people keep saying they want me to sing Al Di Là. And tomorrow I see if I can sing Al Di Là for you. This is addictive. And anyway, let me have a sip of water because we need to drink water, hydrated. So I'm always drinking water. So here's my water. And what can I say? I hope you enjoy the recipe. If you have suggestions of what you want me to cook, I was thinking next Saturday maybe to go back and cook some dessert, some panna cotta with fruits or stuff like that. How would you guys see? Or maybe another pasta or risotto. If you have suggestions, just let me know. You know, I'm always willing. A lot of you are giving me amazing suggestions. And thank you for sharing, by the way. I see a lot of people are sharing it right now. Share, share, share. And you can share and create watch party when we're done with it. That helps me enormously because more people gets to see what I do. So every day more people is tuning in. Doug, are you going to make this recipe with Susie? Believe me, you're going to love it. And you know, when you're going to have this leftover, by the way, because me and JJ, we are a family of two, I'm going to cut in pieces, in portions of two, and I put them in a nice plastic container and I can froze it in the freezer and have it in a week. Or I can put it in the refrigerator if I want to eat the same things tomorrow. Normally, I like to have a different food every day. So normally, I freeze it, and then a week from now, on a Sunday when I don't know what to cook or I'm running behind because I have to go live with you, I take it out and I just put it in the microwave. I defrost it for a temperature of 9 because this is going to take like 10 minutes to defrost, and he's ready. I serve it at the table, and you know what? Sometimes when he's eat it, it's even better than when you just made it because all the ingredients are going next to each other, and it's just super, super delicious. I think we are almost at the end of the thing. So this has been a fantastic adventure. It's the first time, we are trying to see if in the future we can have you coming closer to the stove. JJ said that maybe we're going to have a piece of the kitchen, have a stove here next to me. So do donations so I will be able to add a piece of my kitchen and a little stove. And I always say, pay wherever you can, $1, $2, 50 cents. It doesn't matter. It has to be. It's more that you're helping me to make all these live appearances better. And I know many of you did it. I want to thank Joseph Rainone, who did it, and Veronique Durier. You did it yesterday. So I had Connecticut and all the way the north of France who supported me yesterday, among many other people. So tomorrow is going to be concert time. Tomorrow is going to be singing. It's going to be music. It's going to be fantastic. And what did I forgot to say? Did I forget to mention anything? Just keep happy. I hope you are enjoying these things I do, Giada Live every day. Actually, today is 1 month that we're doing it, right? That's what we're doing. Today we have to celebrate. I don't drink any alcohol, so I can celebrate with water. But if you have a glass, please rise your glass now for me. Se avete un bicchiere, alzatelo adesso per me, qualsiasi cosa state bevendo, e facciamo un cin cin insieme. I've been doing this for 1 month. Ho fatto queste apparizioni per un mese, oggi è un mese, ho iniziato il 18 di marzo. I started the 18th of March, today is the 18th of April, so it's been 1 month that most of you have been with me. So I thank you, cin cin, un cin cin a tutti voi, of Prost, as they say in our country. Grazie per essere stati qui con me, ci vediamo domani for the concert. You can request some, whatever you, and stay tuned because maybe we can put also the end of I made a tune also for the end. So stay and tune in. And thank you, ragazzi, e ci vediamo domani. Giada from Las Vegas, live tomorrow at 2 p.m. Ci vediamo domani. Anche voi, per voi di Instagram. See you tomorrow, guys. Cin cin!
Come lunga questa notte, io non dormo e penso a te. Si confondono i pensieri, io ti amo e non vivrei. E mi trovo a immaginarti, anche quando non ci sei. Come un sasso gettato in mare, soffocando lentamente in te. Il respiro sei di ogni attimo, tu sei il battito che mi fa vivere. Solo con te io posso esistere, solo con te toccando l'eternità. Solo con te, per non lasciarci mai, amore mio. Solo con te, come strano.